transportation in plants and animals, excretion and dialysis. So you know what the blood is made up of and the different types of blood. You were told that blood carries waste products away from the body parts. Let us see how that happens. What are the different ways you pass things out of your body? You pass stools and urine. You even sweat and pass out substances from your body. Passing stuff out of your body is known as excretion. We pass out waste products which are not useful for the body. If we do not pass out these waste products, they could make us ill. The food that we eat passes through the digestive system. The undigested portion passes into the large intestine and is sent out through the body as stools. The fruits and vegetables that we eat contain cellulose which is not used or digested by the body. This cellulose helps in the formation of stools. So, we can help our digestive system by drinking water and eating a healthy diet that includes foods rich in fiber, fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. How do we pass out liquid waste? It comes out as urine. That is formed in the kidneys. Let us see where the kidneys are and what they do. Most people have two healthy kidneys in their body. They look like red-brown peanuts about the size of your fist. Many other parts of your body depend on them. Your kidneys work with all the other organs in your body to keep you healthy. To locate your kidneys, put your hands on your hips. Then slide your hands up until you can feel your ribs. Now, if you put your thumbs on your back, you will know where your kidneys are. You can't feel them, but they are there. One of the main jobs of the kidneys is to filter the waste out of the blood. Chemical reactions occur in the cells of your body to break down the nutrients that the blood brings to them. Some of the waste is the result of these chemical reactions. Some is just stuff your body doesn't need because it already has enough. The waste has to go somewhere. This is where the kidneys come in. We have about 6 liters of blood in our body and the kidneys filter this blood about 400 times a day. More than 1 million tiny filters inside the kidneys remove the waste. These filters, called nephrons, are so small you can see them only with a high-powered microscope. The waste that is collected combines with water, which is also filtered out of the kidneys, to make urine, or what you call pee. As each kidney makes urine, the urine slides down a long tube called the ureter and collects in the bladder, a storage sac that holds the urine. When the bladder is about halfway full, your body tells you to go to the bathroom. When you pee, the urine goes from the bladder down another tube called the urethra and out of your body. You might notice that sometimes your urine is darker in color than other times. Remember, urine is made up of water plus the waste that is filtered out of the blood. If you don't take a lot of fluids or if you're exercising and sweating a lot, your urine has less water in it and it appears darker. If you're drinking lots of fluids, the extra fluid comes out in your urine and it will be lighter. Human urine is mostly water and there is a little bit of urea and other waste. Aquatic animals secrete ammonia, which directly dissolves in the water. Some land animals, like birds and reptiles, secrete a semi-solid white color uric acid. Do you know that in humans, a urine test is even done to diagnose diabetes? When cells of the body do not absorb the sugar in the blood, the sugar stays in the blood. This condition is known as diabetes. That's how diabetes is diagnosed through a urine test. If sugar is found in the urine, that means the person has diabetes. Our kidneys are so strong that we really need only one to be healthy. You can even give one away if they work well. Some people are born with only one kidney and never even know it. When someone's kidneys can no longer do their job and can't get better, a person has chronic kidney disease. A doctor might say the kidneys are failing. This means they are not working well and the person may need help. The person may be losing weight or feeling tired and sick. A medical treatment called dialysis can take over the job of filtering your blood. Through dialysis, a person is hooked up to an artificial filtering system that removes waste from the blood. If possible, the doctor may also replace the kidney with somebody else's healthy kidney. This is called kidney transplant. If the kidneys don't work, the body develops problems like aches and pains, bone problems, itchy skin, and even anemia. Anemia is a condition of the blood in which the hemoglobin is very low. Have you heard of a problem called kidney stone? A kidney stone is an actual stone or a crystal of calcium oxalate that is formed in the kidney. Calcium oxalate is a chemical that is secreted by the liver. We also get it from the food we eat. It forms needle-shaped crystals. If the crystals are small, they pass out through the ureters with no problem. But if they are big, then they get stuck and cause pain. How can you prevent kidney stones from happening? You can drink lots of water and fruit juices. You have to avoid foods that have calcium oxalate, like colocasia, spinach, tomatoes, etc. If you do have a kidney stone, doctors can give you medicines to help get it out. Homeopathy and Ayurveda have medicines to dissolve the kidney stone and prevent it from forming again too. Another way in which water and salts leave your body is through sweat. Your body works best when its temperature is about 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, that is 37 degrees Celsius. When your body gets hotter than that, your brain doesn't like it. It wants your body to stay cool and comfortable. So, the part of your brain that controls temperature, called the hypothalamus, sends a message to your body telling it to sweat. Then, the sweat glands in your skin start making sweat. Sweat contains mostly water, with other chemicals like ammonia, urea, salt, and sugar. It leaves the skin through tiny holes called pores. When the sweat hits the air makes it evaporate. As the sweat evaporates off your skin, you cool down. Sweat is a great cooling system, but if you're sweating a lot on a hot day or after playing hard, you could be losing too much water through your skin. Then, you need to put liquid back in your body by drinking plenty of water so you won't get dehydrated. What did we just learn? Removal of waste products from the body is called excretion. Excretory system of humans consists of two kidneys, two ureters, a urinary bladder, and urethra. Salts and urea are removed along with water as sweat.
If you like our videos, do share them and subscribe to our channel. If you want awesome quizzes, write to us. Keep watching and keep learning with Walnut.